Hello dear student, how are you all? I hope that you all are fine and doing great at your home. This is your subject teacher of English from LPM Public School situated Golabajar, Gorakhpur. Student, welcome back to your online classes. Student, today's video I'm going to explain the exercises of your English reader book. So student, in my previous video we have to learn the story of chapter 13, Time to be a Rock. So we have to learn that in the story there is a little baby turtle who was going for a walk, and he remembered that what his mother taught to him. Okay, so student, now today I'm going to explain the exercises of chapter 13. So let's start the video. So student, here is the first question of chapter number 13. Exercise A. In exercise A, there is a tick the correct words to complete the sentences. Okay students, tick the correct words to complete the sentences. So here the first is Toto lived in. So here is a two option, we have to choose the correct one. So here are two options, A, a pond, and B, the sheep. So student, we have to learn that Toto lived in a pond with his mother and father. So here we have to take the exercise A, Toto lived in a pond. Okay, after that next question is question number second. Toto lived with his grandma, mother and father. Here is two option, first is grandma and second is a mother and father. So we have learned in the story that Toto lived with his mother and father. So here at option B is correct, so we have to take option B. Now the next number third is, one day Toto felt like going for a walk or swim. So student, we have learned that Toto was going to walk. So we have to take option A. Okay, Toto is going for a walk, so here is the option A is correct, so we have to take it. Now the next stage, exercise B. In exercise B, who said this word, write their name on the blank. So student, here is the sentence, we have to write that person name who said this word. Okay, so first is, I will be safe now. I'll be safe now. So this word is said by Toto. We have to write Toto. The spelling of Toto, T-O-T-O, Toto. Now the next is number second. Oh, what a pretty rock. So this word is said by Mimi. Okay, so we have to write the spelling of Mimi, and the spelling of Mimi is M-I-M-I, Mimi. Now the next number third is, time to be a rock. Who said this word? So this word is said by Toto. So we have to write T-O-T-O, Toto. Now the next number four is, what's wrong, Mimi? Who said this word? So Bini said this word. So we have to write Bini. And what's the spelling of Bini? B-I-N-N-I-E, Bini. Now the completing exercise A and B. Now next, moving to the exercise C. In exercise C, there is a answer this question. So student, we have to write down the question answer. Okay, so number first question is, what did Toto want to do? So we all know that Toto want going for a walk. So we have to write going for a walk. In second, what did Toto do when he heard someone coming? So we have learned in the story that when Toto heard scary sound, so he knows that it's time to be a rock. So that time Toto pulled his head into his cell. Okay, now the next, who thought Toto was a pretty rock? So Mimi thought Toto was a pretty rock. So student, you have to write question answer in your notebook. I will explain this question answer in my next video. Okay, now moving to the next, exercise D. So in exercise D, complete the word pairs with word from the box. So student, here you, as you can see, there is a words given in the blanks. We have to choose the correct word and complete the given word pairs. So for example, like this, here is the first, salt, and the pair of salt is paper. So we have to write paper. salt and pepper. Okay, salt and pepper. After that, second is hand. So the pair of hand is fit. So we have to write down fit. F-E-E-T, fit. And number third, doors. So doors and windows. The spelling of window is W-I-N-D-O-W-S. Okay. Fourth is frogs. So frogs and knives. K-N-I-V-E-S, knives. Number five, bread. And so the pair of bread is butter. B-U-T-T-E-R, butter. Now the next, number six is socks. So the pair of socks is shoes. S-H-O-E-S, shoes. Okay. Next is, next number seven is cups. So the pair of cups is saucer. S-A-U-C-E-R-S, saucers. Next is lock. The pair of lock is key. So we have to write key. K-E-Y, key. Now the next, after completing the exercise D, now moving to the next exercise. This is exercise E. In exercise E, circle the meaning of the words in pink. So student, we have to choose the correct meaning of the given words. So first word is tiny. And here is a three option. Three meaning of tiny. First is huge, second is quick, and fourth is small. So we all know that meaning of tiny is small. So we have to circle the correct meaning. It is small, S-M-A-L-L, small. Second is scared. So the meaning of scared is frightened. So we have to circle the correct meaning of scared, F-R-I-G-S-T-E-N-E-D, frightened. Okay. Next, number third is jungle. So we all know that meaning of jungle is forest, F-O-R-E-S-T, forest. Number fourth is sharp, and the meaning of sharp is pointed, P-O-I-N-T-E-D, pointed. Okay students, like this you have to circle the correct meaning of the given words. Now you have also learned this given word meaning. Okay, this given word meaning you have to learn. Now the next number, next is exercise F. In exercise F, fill in the missing letter to complete the name of these things. So student, we have to fill the correct letters and complete the given words. Okay, according to the picture, we have to fill the correct letters, correct missing letters. Okay, so number one, as you can see, what is this? This is grass, and here is a G-R-S. So we have to fill the correct spelling of grass. So the spelling of grass is G-R-A-S-S, grass. And second, what is this? This is train. And the spelling of train is T-R-A-I and train. So we have to fill A-I. Next is number third. What is this? This is a frog. And the spelling of frog is F-R-O-C-K, frog. So we have to fill O and C. And after that, the last one is S-H dash P. So we have to fill I here. It becomes the spelling of ship, S-H-I-P, ship. Okay students, so now moving to the next. Next is exercise G. What will we do in exercise G? So it is a grammar fun for you. Use and to join the words. So here we have to fill and to joining the given words. Okay, so first there is a hand, there's a chick. So we have to write and, a hand and a chick. Okay. Next is a lion and a mouse. Here we again write and for joining these two words. Okay. Now the next is a triangle, there's a rectangle. So we have to write and for joining this word. Now number four is an owl. There's a ladybird. So we have to write an owl and a ladybird. Okay students, so now moving to the next, after completing exercise G, we have to do the next exercise H. So what will we do in exercise H? In exercise H, fill in the blanks with the correct words. Fill in the blanks with the correct word. So student, we have to choose the correct word which is given in the brackets, and after that we have to write down on the given blanks. So in number one, you can write with a pencil dash a pen. So here is two option, or but. So we have to choose the correct word or. Okay, you can write with a pencil or a pen. Second is Pooja opened the window, Dash looked out. So we have to choose and. A-N-D, and. Number third, the sun had set, Dash, it was not dark. We have to write or, okay? So the sun had set or it was not dark. Next, number four. Student, here we have to write but, okay? In number third, we have to write but. This is the correct. We have to use but, okay? The sun had set, but it was not dark. Next, number four. I have a toy train. Dash, I cannot find it. So, we have to write, I have a toy train, but I cannot find it. Number five. Nido loves to sing. Dash, dance. So, we have to choose and. Nido loves to sing and dance. Okay, students. So, like this, you have to complete this given exercises one by one with a good handwriting. I hope you all are understood that how to complete your book one by one according to the exercises. Student, you have also complete and after that write these exercises in your notebook with a good handwriting and you have to learn it. Okay, student. So, student, I hope is that clear to you. So that's it for today. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy. Thank you.